Hi, this is Aditya, and I'm going to basically go through some pivot table and basic pivot graph concepts. I'm using Excel 2007 over here. So as an example, I'm basically using a fictitious company salary report. And there are two departments, sales and marketing, each having two managers and employees under them, and this is their salary. I think one of the biggest improvements Microsoft has made in this version of Excel is the ease in which you can create a pivot table. Those of you familiar with Office 2003 and Excel 2003's pivot table functionality may have had a few challenges trying to understand the concept initially. To create a pivot table, you would first select the table. So I'm going to first click inside one of these cells and go to the Insert tab here on the ribbon and click on the Pivot Table button. As you can see, it automatically recognizes the table. If it doesn't do that, then you can just drag the cells and mark the table. And in this example, I'm going to create it in the existing worksheet. So I'm going to say existing worksheet, and I'm going to click on the cell where I want the pivot table to appear. Click on OK. And the order in which you check these checkboxes is very important. So the aim over here is to try and figure out what is the total and average salaries per department and also per manager. Now we want this numbers by department, by manager. So it's very important you click on department first and then manager. If you do the other way around, which is clicking on manager first and then department, you would then see it takes the manager as your overall and department under them. So I'm going to uncheck these and check it in the correct order, department, manager. And this is the kind of format we want. We want to see marketing, and then you have Nick and Tom under marketing, and then we have sales with Chris and Jeff under sales. I'm going to go ahead and click on the salary checkbox, and what Excel does is it automatically recognizes that it's a numeric value, and so it takes the sum by default and shows it. And as you can see, we have the sum for reports under Nick as 391,000 and Tom 235,000, and marketing's total is 626,000, and the grand total is 1,335,500. Let's say we want the average as well. So you would take salary, you click on it and drag it to the values section over here. And by default, it shows sum again. So the second sum, you click on this value, click on value field settings and choose average. And you can actually give a custom name. So I'm just going to say average. And it shows up the average. And I can rename this to sum. Now, as you can see, these numbers are pretty much good for numbers, but these are dollar values. So I'm going to select these cells, go to the home ribbon, and you can see this dollar icon under the number section. So I click on this, and voila, it's all dollars. Now you see hash, hash, hash over here, and this indicates that the cell size is too small for the value to fit. So I'm just going to resize the cell. And there you go. Alternatively, you can get your mouse, get this icon here, double click, and it auto sizes the cell. So looking at this, marketing is $626,000, sales $704,500, and the average is $89,428 for marketing, 57 cents of course, and $88,062.50 for sales. And you can expand and collapse these, and you know it's very useful when you have multiple values. Let's say you want to factor the employee in as well. You can just click on employee and then it shows the employee salary. In this case, it's pretty much the same data you have over here, so it doesn't add much value unless you want to take a full snapshot. So I'm going to deselect employee. Another cool feature is you have marketing. You want to figure out how the $626,000 number appeared. So you can right-click on the cell and select Show Details. And it shows in a new sheet the details of all the employees under marketing and their salary. So this is a good breakdown. So this is extremely useful when you're trying to navigate between the pivot table. Now, one caveat over here is that this is a an Excel 2007 format. So if you were to save this file in the compatibility mode, which is XLS, or the Office 2003 format, the pivot table will not appear. It'll appear as a simple table. It'll not be interactive for anyone who opens this file in Excel 2003. So in Excel 2003, it's a little different. So what I have open in a separate window is another file in the 2003 compatibility format. Now this file is test.xlsx, which is basically a 2007 format. So we're fine over here. I'm now going to go to XLS. This is a compatibility mode. You can see on the top, test.xls, compatibility mode. Same features, basically the same way you would create a pivot table, or click a cell on the table, go to the Insert tab, click on Pivot Table. It automatically detects the table, existing worksheet, and I want to place my pivot table over here. Now, this type of outline will look familiar for those of you who have created pivot tables in 2003 version of Excel. Again, here the order of which you check these boxes matters. So by department, by manager. So here you can see that rather than have a hierarchy view within the same cell, each level of hierarchy moves over to the next column. So I'm going to have my salary. I am going to have the average. Now, another way of selecting this as an average is you can actually right-click in this column and say summarize data by average. And there you go. So I'm going to make this average sum and select these, go to home, get it to the dollar format. Now, if you're using any other currency, you can choose this drop down. So you have dollar, pound, euro, the Chinese currency by default. Again, it depends on how your computer is configured. You can go to more accounting formats, and you have a lot of symbols like Mongolian and basically a lot of currencies over here. And then you do have some Arabic, Persian, Punjabi, Bengali, you know, various languages. And then you have the three letter ISO codes for the currency. So let's say I select Ukrainian, and it just shows you the way the Ukrainian currency is. So this is in 2003. The details as well, marketing total, I can right click and say show details, and it shows me the details. Now, there's a little bit of time to go through the pivot graph. So I'm going to come back here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to get rid of this pivot table. I'm going to go to Insert, Pivot Table, Pivot Chart. So in this case, it didn't detect because I didn't select the table. So I'm going to select the range as a range, existing worksheet in this location. I click on OK. This is the chart. I'm going to say my department manager and salary totals. And as you can see, the graph is generated over here. And it's a pretty cool graph. You have Nick, Tom, their totals, marketing. It's grouped by marketing, the department. Have about 17 seconds left in the video. I'm going to try and get average in as well. So click here, click here, click here. There's your average. Let's say I don't want some. Try and delete this. Can't. And we're done with the video. So thank you for watching.